Hello all, welcome to the channel Learn Everything Karka Kasadara. In this video, we are going to see about some simple operations which can be done using lathe machine, and they are facing and plane turning. Facing is a process which is used to remove material at the ends of the workpiece, and turning is a process of removing excess material from a workpiece to produce a cylindrical surface. So if a material is having irregular shape and if you are going to convert into a cylindrical component, then you have to go for plane turning operation. So before going into the experiment or operation, let us now have a very small understanding about the dimensions of the workpiece. So the initial workpiece will be given at a length of 82 mm, all the dimensions are in mm. The length of the initial workpiece or before machining, it is 82 mm, and the diameter of the workpiece is around 20 mm, and you have to convert this 82 mm into 80 mm. And you have to reduce the diameter of the workpiece from 20 to 18 mm. This is what the target, or this is what we are going to do. So initially, the length of the workpiece is 82 mm. We have to reduce it to 80 mm by means of facing. And you have to reduce the diameter from 20 to 18 mm by using plane turning operation. This is the workpiece we are going to machine now. We are going to do facing and turning operation on this workpiece. Initially, you have to check the dimensions of the workpiece. Here we are using vernier caliper for measuring the dimension. You can see the diameter of the workpiece is more than 19 and less than 20 mm. You have to check the coincidence of the zero marking, and the length of the workpiece is 82 mm. Now it's time to fix the workpiece on the chuck. The space between the tip of the surface gauge and the surface of the workpiece will give you a small identification about irregularities on the surface of the workpiece. You can see a small wobbling of the workpiece when you switch on the machine. When the tip of the surface gauge touches the workpiece, the sound is not uniform. It shows that there is some irregularity on the surface of the component and it should be sorted out. A gentle tap on the workpiece is more than enough to avoid this mismatch. Now you can see it is very uniform. And finally, we are tightening up the workpiece. This is a single point cutting tool which is made of high speed steel, and it is used for making facing, turning and taper turning. We are fixing it in tool post. And then we have to align this tool with respect to the axis of the lathe. It has been done by the help of dead center. The tip of the dead center and the tip of the tool should be on the same line. For facing operation, the tool post is slightly tilted in order to have a rigid contact of the tip of the tool on the workpiece. So you can see the tip of the tool is touching the workpiece without any deviation or disturbance. Since the length of the component is 82 mm, at this particular end, we are just doing a simple facing operation, which is a smoothening process. We'll maintain dimensional accuracy on the other end of the component. So now at one end the surface is very smooth. Now it's time for turning operation. For turning, the tool should be in perpendicular direction with respect to the axis of the lathe so that the tip will directly touch the workpiece. Turning is a process of reducing the diameter of the workpiece. For making turning operation, the tip of the tool should touch the workpiece in order to indicate the initial reading. The cross lathe should move in transverse direction by means of adjusting this knob. So now we are just taking one reading. So here every indication is 0.05 mm. So we are making 1 mm depth of cut. And the entire carriage should move in longitudinal direction. Once after giving 1 mm depth of cut, you have to move the entire carriage using the other knob. So here while moving, it should be very gentle and there should not be any jerky movement. If there is any jerky movement, it will directly reflect over the component. You can feel some scratches over the component if the movement is jerky. So it should be very smooth and gentle. You can see his hands. It is moving very gentle and smooth. He is not stopping anywhere. So it is continuously moving. While moving, you should be very careful. The carriage should not touch the chuck. It may lead to accidents. So once after reaching a proper distance, come back to the original position and check the dimension of the component. The line with respect to 0 is not exactly coinciding with 19 mm. It is slightly greater than 19 mm. So we are going to give a depth of cut of 1 mm now. So in this knob, every division is 0.05 mm. So with respect to 1 mm, we have to rotate the knob. So once after giving the depth of cut, it is time to move the carriage in longitudinal direction as moved in previous step. And he is Mr. Radhakrishnan, technician of National Engineering College. Thank you, Radhakrishnan sir, for spending your time and sharing your knowledge with us. At initial stage, you can give a rough turning, but as the stages goes on, the turning should be very fine and smooth because that will be the final end product. The material removed from the component is known as chips. So you should be very careful to move the carriage. It should not touch the chuck. It will create accident. Once after reaching the safe point, you have to switch off the machine and again you have to take the dimension. Here you can see the line with respect to 0 is not coinciding with 18 mm. So you have to check the other lines also. The second line from number 1 is exactly coinciding, which means the dimension is 18.14. This is what the dimension or diameter of the workpiece. It is 18.14. By rotating the knob for two divisions, we can give a depth of cut of 0.1 mm. Make a note of this value, it is 16, because this will be useful for the other side. Every division counts 0.05. we are just rotating to 2 divisions. Since the accuracy of cross slide is 0.05 mm, we cannot match the accuracy of lathe with respect to vernier caliper. So we can only reduce 0.1 mm diameter. The remaining 0.04 mm cannot be reduced, because the least count or least value we can reduce is only 0.05. This is our final machining process. It should be very firm and gentle. You can see some very fine particles which is being removed from the component. It should be very smooth and gentle. When you are doing the final machining process, you should be very careful to have a gentle operation. That's all, the final machining is over. Now switch off the machine and again check the dimensions. Now you can see it is coinciding with 18, so we have reduced the diameter to 18 mm. And the next step is, we have to bring back the carriage to the initial position and we have to machine the other side of the component. So you can clearly see the deviations of the diameter and also the smoothness. The surface is very smooth. Remain the value what you have kept in the previous stage of machining, it is 16. You have to keep the same value here in order to remove same amount of material from the component to get the same output. Again repeat the process. I'm repeating, it should be very gentle and firm. There should not be any jerk. You can see his hands, it is moving very gentle. Turning operation is over. The material is very smooth. Now it's time to check the length of the component. The component will be very hot. You cannot touch it with your bare hands. Since he is a trained personnel, he is holding it, but even he finds difficult to hold the component. So now check the length of the component using the vernier caliper. You can see the line with respect to 0 is coinciding with 81, which means the length of the component is 81 mm. So we have to reduce 1 mm. In order to do facing, you have to slightly tilt the tool and gently touch the tool on the workpiece. For reducing 1 mm, you have to rotate this knob to 5 divisions, because each division is 0.2 mm. So 5 into 0.2 is 1 mm. Once after fixing the value, then you have to move the cross light in transverse direction. Again, you should be very gentle and bring back the carriage to the initial position. Now it's time to check the dimension of the component. Even though we have reduced 1 mm, the 0 is not exactly coinciding with 80. This may be because of some uneven surfaces on the workpiece. So here you can see number 6 is coinciding, so which means the length is around 80.6. So you have to reduce 0.6 mm again. For that, the tip of the tool should touch the surface of the workpiece. So here in the carriage you have to give 3 divisions. So each and every division is around 0.2 mm. So 3 divisions, rotating 3 divisions will give a depth of 0.6 mm. So we have reduced from 82 to 80 mm, and also we have reduced the diameter from 20 to 18 mm. So this is what the final component is. I hope you have got some information related to facing and plane turning. I'll meet you in the next video with a new content. Thank you for watching.